That's Lexi.
And that's Tyler.
And this is your Charger Report.
We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance. And if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. I say we can go where we want to. A place where they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world. Leave the real one far behind. And we can dance.
Jurors heard opening statements and the first witnesses on Tuesday in the trial of Michael Jackson's doctor, who is charged with involuntary manslaughter in the pop icon's death. Will he be held responsible, or did he even do anything to cause the pop artist's death? We'll keep you updated.
If you've been following the story of Amanda Knox, you know that there is no physical evidence to show that she committed the murder she was accused of. The defense now has their chance to release the innocent girl, American Girl. Borgerino compared Knox to the cartoon character Jessica Rabbit, who protests, "I'm not bad, I'm just drawn that way," in the movie Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Well, Tyler, this past week has been rainy and cloudy.
I know. Have you heard what next week's going to be like?
No, not yet.
All right, well, let's ask Philip.
Thanks, guys. This week in forecast, we have sun and more sun. And that's just the entire week of sun. And then we have the high in the mid-70s and the low for the week. Now, this is pretty cold, mid-40s. Are you guys ready for this freezing weather coming, like, next month? I'm excited.
Thanks so much for that report, Philip. Alec Baldwin broke Saturday Night Live records Saturday. He has now hosted more than 16 SNLs, more than any other actor, singer, or even clown. Baldwin made sure to mention his new record during his opening monologue on Saturday Night Show.
As you may have heard, we have had an outbreak of Bullet East. This outbreak is known as scabies. They are little mites that burrow into your skin and lay little scabie baby eggs. To make sure you don't get them, avoid prolonged contact with people who may have scabies.
So, Lexi, what do you think about the ACT?
I think that it's a good test and it's a great way to get into college. Why do you ask?
Well, I was just wondering what other people thought about the ACT.
Actually, I think Danton, our field reporter, has a special report about that. Danton?
The people in charge of Bullitt County Education have created a rule stating that all students whose graduation year is 2015 and after must meet a graduation requirement involving test scores on the ACT. If they don't meet these graduation requirements, they cannot pass. We asked people what they thought about this.
Did you guys know that there's a new requirement that for freshmen you have to have at least a 20 on the ACT to graduate?
No, I didn't know that.
Didn't know anything at all, man.
I didn't know that.
That's crazy. That's insane. That's insanity. There's no way I can make a 20 on the ACT. I feel sorry for them.
Did you guys know that for your class you have to score at least a 20 on the ACT to graduate?
Yes.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
That's not a problem because I got a 21?
I think it's ridiculous.
I think it sucks.
Why?
Because why would you want a 20?
I feel as though like it's not fair to freshmen. Like they have to work so hard and stuff just to get to pass school and stuff. They should at least get the grade that they make. That's what I say.
The ACT is ridiculous. It's ridiculously hard. Get out of my shot.
It's pretty dumb. Really dumb. Really, really dumb.
Why do you think it's dumb?
Because like not everyone's a good test taker, and like people might fail and like might not graduate.
Do you have any idea of where you'd like to go to college or if you want to go to college?
I'm not going to college.
Why not?
I don't want to.
Okay, then. So you don't need any ACT for that, do you?
I don't think so.
No, actually, I'm going to dig ditches for a smaller. That's my plans.
You don't need an ACT score there, do you?
No, not at all.
I would like to go to UK.
Ohio State.
Well, did you know that in order to get into UK, you have to have a minimum of 22 to get in?
Nope, did not know.
Sucks for you.
WKU?
EKU or Northern Kentucky?
Well, to get into WKU, you have to have at least a 20 on the ACT. And to get into EKU, you have to have at least a 21 on the ACT.
I'm going to Northern.
Hey, I scored a 21.
I'm going to Northern then. Got to have 18, I know that.
Are you taking the ACT this year at all?
I'm probably going to take it again.
Do you know what time?
No. No.
Oh, okay, okay. Well, you probably figure that out so you can get on top of that.
I will, Dan.
I've already taken it once. Actually, twice.
Are you guys planning on taking the ACT anytime soon?
No.
Yes. Yes. Soon.
Anytime this year?
Maybe. I don't know. I'm not sure yet.
I've already took it.
Yes, I will be taking it. Don't know the date, though.
All right. Good deal.
As you can see, not many people are in favor of the new requirements. Boy, are they in for a surprise.
Another rule being enforced this year, and it's causing teachers to yell, "Step out of that car!" This rule is not new, but students are not allowed to sit in their cars in the morning when they come in early. Some students like to eat in their car, some students like to rest before they come in. Regardless, in order to stay out of trouble, we recommend that you come straight into school.
We at the Charger Report would like to give a big shout out to the marching band. Good luck at your competition this weekend. Go get 'em, marching Chargers!
Well, Tyler, it seems like it's that time in the show again.
Where we get to dance?
When have we ever done that?
Never, but when's a better time to start than right now?
We can't do that right now. We have wacky news.
Oh, fine.
Thanks to you guys so much. Today in the wacky news, I've got a story from the United States. Represent. All right, so apparently there's this couple that got a tree in the backyard, and they went out, and it's a pear tree, but they found a pumpkin growing in it. I don't know. What had happened is a vine ran away from home from the vineyard next door and started growing up the tree and started sprouting pumpkins inside the pear tree, right? So the couple hopes that the pumpkins will remain until they turn orange in the tree. And it'd be a very nice pick. And you know, as the old, you know, Christmas song goes, for the first day of Christmas, my true love grew for me, a pumpkin in a pear tree. Thanks, guys, and then back to you.
I'm Lexi.
And I'm Tyler.
And this has been your Charger Report.
See you next time. Oh, Lexi, did I tell you I had scabies?
This week's shows to look forward to are Terra Nova, Glee, Modern Family, and Revenge.
All these shows have had the most viewings on their season premieres.
The CW is developing a new reality series based on our traditional game, Musical Chairs. Phil Garvin developed the ABC show Shark Tank, and the CMT's Singing Bee is behind Extreme Musical Chairs. This competition is more physical and intense, but as of right now, there is no set air date or time frame.
Our movie of the week is Moneyball.
At a showing of 2 hours and 6 minutes, based on a true story, this movie has everyone talking. Check it out.
Billy Bean has tried to reinvent a system that's been working for years. It was a nice theory, just not working out.
How long is Billy Bean gonna last?
He's proven himself right out of a job.
In their minds, it's threatening the game. It's threatening the way that they do things.
Hey, Daddy, do you think you'll lose your job?
What? Where'd you hear that?
Well, I go on the internet sometimes.
Don't go on the internet. Watch TV or talk to people.
You're discounting what scouts have done for 150 years?
What the hell am I doing?
What is happening in Oakland?
It defies everything we know about baseball.
Just plain crazy.
If we win with this team, we'll change the game.
Yeah, that looks like a pretty good movie. In other movie news, the opening of Creature had the worst box office record ever. It grossed in $3,100,000 and was shown in over 1,500 theaters. It was the worst opening for a film that showed in over 1,500 locations. Don't believe everything you read on Twitter. On Wednesday, a rumor spread like a wildfire that soccer star David Beckham had died in a fiery car crash.
From what we've been able to gather from various rumors and tweets is that Beckham had lost control while driving on Interstate 80. Rest assured that he is okay, though. Speaking of Twitter, let's go over to Cody with our field report.
Facebook's got a new look. Not that many people like it, so they're switching to Twitter. See what Bullish thinks about it.
Here with
Alan Spencer.
Going to ask him a few questions about Facebook and Twitter.
Which ones do you like better, Facebook or Twitter?
I'm partially a fan of Twitter and maybe a little Facebook.
I'm going to ask him about Facebook and Twitter and which one they prefer more. Haley, which one do you prefer more, Facebook or Twitter?
Facebook.
Facebook.
That's all the way down.
Facebook, because Twitter kind of just sucks.
Facebook.
Facebook.
Can y'all tell me why?
Start there.
Because you stay connected with all your friends.
I like Facebook because you can post pictures, look at statuses, and send private messages.
Get a life.
Because you can check up on people, I guess.
Twitter's just updates and Facebook has a lot more, so I like it better.
Well, it looks like people on Bullities like Facebook better than Twitter.
So what's Twitter?
Now we're to Alicia with Toon Generation.
Hola, Bullities. This is Alicia with your Toon Generation segment. Yay! This week is a special week. You may be asking yourself why, and I'm saying to you, it's because there's a party! Ah, I'm so excited! Many of you have heard about the iHeartRadio Music Festival in Las Vegas. This concert features Lady Gaga, Coldplay, and the Black Eyed Peas, and other big hit music icons. Tickets were won for the big festival for the past month on our loved radio station 98.9. Congratulations to all the winners. This big bash went down at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas September 23rd and 24th. Lights, cameras, guys, awesome musician, guys, outrageous dancing, and did I mention guys? Anyways, a hot weekend for a big city. Well, that's it for Toon Generation. Signing off for the last time. I give you love, Adios Chargers.
I'm sorry, did I hear boys?
I think you did. Now over to Trace with video games.
With new additions to the online co-op and an improved online roster, Madden 12 offers various new features never before seen in a Madden game. I like Madden 12, but there are a few defaults with the game. The scrimmage and free play mode mean major improvements. I expect Madden 13, whenever it comes out, to be much better. Gotta wait till next October, though. I give Madden 12 a 4 out of 5. Could be better, could be worse.
I'm Taylor.
And I'm Jamie.
And this was your Vab.
What's up, Bullities? I'm Chase.
And I'm Emily.
And this is your Red Zone Sports Report. Pinman Hills High School in San Jose, California, cheerleaders are being forced to wear sweats under their miniskirts to avoid violating dress code. The cheerleaders say they feel like they are an outcast and it is unfair. I think it was fine the way it was before.
Jerome Simpson, Cincinnati Bengals wide receiver, was caught with a 2.5-pound shipment of marijuana. Bengals tackle Anthony Collins was with Simpson when the marijuana was impounded, later to find 5 pounds at his house, but neither were arrested.
You feel that?
The Chargers took on E-Town September 17th and came away with the win 2-1, and two fans got thrown out.
Last Thursday, boys' soccer team took on Northport and came away with the win, 4-1. Great way to end senior night, fellas.
Those were some nice highlights, guys. One of the top Catholic football teams in the nation are finding themselves in hot water after directing chants to the opponent saying, "We've got Jesus," in a heated rivalry game.
A banana was thrown from the stands in London, Ontario, at Flyers winger Wayne Simmons. I never knew a banana could cause so much problems in a National Hockey League.
Me neither. Let's go to Gage for some volleyball highlights.
Bullies traveled to Central Hardin last Friday, coming off their 55-0 win, looking to get the same results. Unfortunately, Central Hardin came out unwilling to cooperate. The touchdown in the first quarter by Dylan Lewis and another in the fourth by Jesse Porter, the Chargers were handed a loss 28-14. Tune in next time, boys.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name. He doesn't need his name up in lights, he just wants to be heard, whether it's the beat or the mic, he feels so unlike.
That was one great game.
Andover, Minnesota High School cross-country star Josh Ripley stopped and carried an injured runner a half mile back to coaches and family members. The runner had 60 stitches all around his ankle. All he had to say about it was, "I had to stop and help him."
As many of you have been watching Monday Night Football, Ron Jaworski, ESPN analysis, announced he would like to apologize for the language used on the last airing. Not a big deal, clearly, but he just forgot he was on air.
Holy Now it's time for Around the Horn.
Hi, I'm Gage, and this is your Around the Horn time. Bullet Central travels to Mike Egan Field to play the Chargers. What do you guys think?
Well, last time they were there, the Bullet East actually lost to Bullet Central, but that's also when they had a very good player for Bullet Central. Let's see how it works out.
I think we're going to win this one. I think we're going to take home. We're going to take home that W, son. We're going to take it home. Everybody has to do work. Do work.
Woo!
I totally agree with Jordan and T.
I think it's going to be a tough game because I think Bullet Central is going to come out pretty hard.
I think as long as they all work together, we should be good and pull out a win.
This is Bullet East's year. This is their year. A lot of smack talk has been going on. This is their year.
All right, we just got to come out and play and be focused, and I think Bullet East will get the W.
Hold on to the ball. Hold on to the ball. No fumbles. The line needs to drive.
Make good tackles on defense.
Running backs need to stop being babies and run people over instead of juking.
All right, guys, that was some good points. Now let's go to a different topic. Boys and girls soccer is getting ready to run into district play. What do you guys think?
I think as long as they keep up their chemistry, they should have a good game.
Yeah, they just need to play together and come out focused and eat a good meal before they play.
In soccer, you can't really be a ball hog. You have to pass the ball a lot, keep up your team's motivation.
Yeah, I think they need to do more than eat a good meal. District's tough this year, I know. Girls soccer have been losing a few games lately. They need to get their stuff together.
Yeah, but I think if they have, you know, the energy and the focus, I think they will end up winning a lot of the district games.
If they had the want to, then they'll win. You have to have the want to and everything. If you have the attitude, you'll win.
Definitely agree with T2.
And I think they will have the attitude if they eat a good meal.
What's the meal have to do with it?
All right. Well, you heard it, Bullet East. Eat a good meal and have good district play. That's around the horn.